Okay. Finished most of it. Still got some French fries. There's a Starbucks. Into the downtown area. See a lot of people walking. So here we go to the circle. There's Main Avenue. Don't have a road though. Streets are real bumpy. Down to Quincy Street. Okay, so I'm going to go back to North Main. Or San Pedro. And then I'm going to make a left instead of a right. There's a lot of construction on the right-hand side. Okay. Now, this is Baptist Health. There's a hospital right here. It's kind of neat. Going underneath the, you can see the building going, it connects both the north and, well, I should say east and west tower. I-35 is just to the left of me. I think we're going to McCullough. And make a right. $3.15 for gas, that's pretty good. There's kind of like a restaurant or something there. Now, I haven't gone down this way before. So there's North St. Mary's. I'm going south, southeast. And we're coming upon the Riverwalk. But I think it's kind of neat when you get different buildings. See, Broadway is all torn apart. I don't know if they're working on buildings or on the road, but they're really tearing it apart big time. So I'll be going down Avenue E, which you'll know. I'm just on the outskirts of the city. Downtown is just east of me, to the right. So I'm at the northern border. You see the Antelope Street? I might take the Antelope. This is North Alamo, okay? This is the area I was there before. Third Street. So I usually come in from the left. So I can either go down this way. I'm going to go right. Travis, but I see a horse and buggy. Ooh, shit. I just ran a red light. Did not see that. I want to get in the right lane. I don't want to spook the horse. There's a wonderful church to the left. Yeah, I was waiting for the car to do that. It's nice. Nice horse and buggy. I like that. I don't know if they have anybody in the buggy. Yeah, they do. So I'm going west. All right, look at this tower. I'm gonna bring up my camera. Isn't that something? Isn't that gorgeous? I forget where I had the camera. I think it looks pretty spectacular. Thank you. big tall skyscraper I was showing you is a frost bank. Yeah, let's go down with Cameron. I like Cameron. It's kind of pretty. With all the trees and plants, lights. Said the right lane was closed, but I didn't see it closed. So there's something done. I think I'll go to North St. Mary's. That's a sign right there. I see quite a few Starbucks around here. There's Durian and Aztec Theater. And a church. St. Mary's. Walk. There's Commerce. There's Market Street. there's Navarro. I like going down Navarro. Usually you see, yeah, a lot of horses lined up here. Yeah. That's why I went this way. Like a taxi service. I don't know if they pick a horse and buggy or they pick the first one and go. Road construction. I wonder if it hurts any businesses, you know, with these road closures and stuff. Riverwalk. Alright, there's Maine again. Well, you know, I don't know if they have a road going there or not. See, this is a funny street right here. You gotta stop. Yes, you can make a right, but I'm not really at the corner. The reason why I like going down this street is besides hotels and tall buildings and, you know, this little plaza right here, it's quiet. I mean, it's a nice area. cross tower. Big building I showed you. But, you know, this is a nice path walk. There's West Travis. That's when it came down and then I made a left. In fact, I'm gonna make a right here. Houston Street. I can make a left and then this is my favorite street, Houston. But you see, I couldn't go down this way. It was blocked. So I usually had to make a left here. First clip was going downtown for about 30 minutes. This one, I've been downtown for 30 minutes. So I think I'll call it Prelude Downtown and then Outro. Streets, and there's a majestic Spider-Man into the spider. So I didn't put it at the minus, but look at the lights. Isn't that wonderful? The only thing that ruined it was the cars. saw me walking down here. So there's the post office. The animal's to the right. East Avenue. And there's Third. I parked right up the street from here. Took some pictures of this building in the left-hand corner. Yeah, they got a lot of time to make a left or right. I mean, walk across the street. Now I just have to watch out for this bus, make sure it doesn't hit me. So you can see a lot of different shops to the right, and then there's kind of like apartments or hotel rooms on top of that. So there's Houston. You know what, I'm gonna go straight. Hotels left and right, front, the Hilton. So here's the horses. I already went by them. I'm just trying to give you different types of here at Commerce. made a right. I'm going to go right here. Navarro. Goodness. Went down to Houston Street to the right. Travis Park. East Pecan Street. I see a lot of people on the benches. Jefferson. Boy, that's a big truck. Found a space though. I thought this was kind of nice. If that car wasn't in front of me, you would see three horse and buggies. One on the left, two on the right. They're making rights, all three of them. There's the Frostbank Tower again. Thank you. trees. It's been down here before, but you know, I want to make a ride to Houston. North Main. Coming up. I can make a left here. There's Commerce. There's Flores. There's the City Hall. Making a left at Dolorosa. Construction again. Once again, Troy Hotel, and I'm on my way out of the city. Just wanted to show you some of the sights with this little bitty camera. It's a powerhouse. Watch out for this guy to the left, but he's going in there. Okay. So it's usually like every other street can make a left and then right. Most of the streets are one way. Some streets are both ways. Oh, there's a horse and buggy. This is why I stay in this lane. You know, the people always picking them up on the sidewalk, so. There's Prussia. Horse and buggy. I'm gonna let this guy go ahead of me. Just want to show you this. So this is perfect time. It's 97 degrees here, so it's always a little bit warmer. Okay. In downtown area with all the cement. Hey, he's going faster than me. That's all right. Okay. So I hope you enjoyed it. See, the flaring is getting a little outrageous. And I'm going to leave it on here. Because some people like seeing stuff like this. So, you know, with the sun, you know, it was dark in the morning. And then it was a little bit brighter. Something happened to the camera, so I had to reset everything, put in a new date and time. It's one of those days. And it could have been, you know, the dummy battery. You know, batteries will do that to the LCD screens also on the camera. So see, I was going like 55 miles an hour because of all these sharp turns. I was going 60, but 55 is being pretty prudent. Straight. I could be wrong. I It says 60 miles an hour, but I'm going 55 just to be safe. So it should be one more turn to the right, and then that should be it. Those are construction vehicles. Yep, putting out barrels. It's 88 degrees now. So just by leaving downtown, which was like 96, 97 degrees, it's, and you know, I could drive a mile and it's now 89. But I could have, I also just lowered my air conditioning. And the funny thing is I could be washing the car. The temperature would drop. So so 281 is right in the center of the city, north to south. 35 and 37. Are on the east or west side of the city. And then Interstate 10 is on the southern part of the city. That's the downtown area that is. Airport to the right. This is the 410 interchange. 281. So you see, it went back to 91 degrees. If you're around a whole bunch of cement, it's going to be warm. 92. So if I turn up the air conditioner, I'm going to test to see if it gets cooler. See, it's only 9:14. Parkway. I'm seeing a little stuttering. So I may have to do something with the camera again. And they may have it with the camera, the ND filter comes on automatic. That's probably what could have been happening today. I don't know what was going on. Here's the runway. Light on the bottom of that car right there. Red light. That's interesting. So, not all police cars are sedans, they're trucks also, and sport cars. I would report if there was any racing going on around the town, but after they passed that new law, everything quieted down. One-fifteenth of a shutter speed. That's why it's stuttering. Oh my goodness. See, now it's at 1/30th, okay? I don't know why it went to 1/50th of a shutter speed. Unless it was having a hard time writing to the SD card. Usually it doesn't go slower than 1/30th. And it's 91 degrees out here. So I was at some low points, which is basically over the aquifer, where it was cooler. Got down to 82 degrees. Now it's back up to 91. See, went back to 1/15th of the shutter speed. Okay, let me try something here. See if that helped. Yeah, went to 1/30th. They want a minus one on the exposure. Isn't that something? Now it's back to 1/15th. It's at f2.8. So they want the minus one exposure. Isn't that something? You can see how black the night sky is. It's at f2.8, 1/30th of shutter speed, minus one exposure compensation. I see some lights. Barrels. Ramp closed. Okay. They're doing something. about 60 miles an hour. You have to go slower. Yeah, I'm going 55 now. Yeah, because the two cars right there. One has his flashers on. It on video. Transferred any files to the computer tonight. I left early. Peter.
Hey, Randy. How you doing?
Pretty good. I'm finishing my ride right now.
Oh, am I interrupting?
No, no. I drove downtown, so I'm still vlogging a little bit, but I'll be home in about 5 minutes. You want me to call you back?
Yeah, that'd be better.
Okay. Bye. Folks, that was Peter Gregg. Okay, so we're coming to the end. This is a minus one exposure, 1/30th of a shutter speed. This is Sony's decision. Is that something? Intelligent Auto might have been something different. So, I was seeing stutter. I've never seen it act up like this before. But the ZV10 did better than this one tonight. And I'm kind of missing the R8 because it's a full frame camera. It's smaller than my other full frame cameras. Well, except for the A7C. Well, I never have a problem with A7C. Yeah. Compared to what I'm seeing tonight. So, anyway. Yeah. Make sure I missed it. So, I just want to say thank you for watching. Give me a like, subscribe. Any questions or comments, put it down below. And remember, stay safe and keep smiling. I shall see you next time. Goodbye, folks.